Hello everybody, welcome to the algorithm course. In this video, I'm going to walk through the counting sort process. So the counting sort process involves these five steps. First, we need to count the number of occurrences of each element, and then we find the cumulative count of the elements. Then we search for the cumulative count for each element in the unsorted list. And then we subtract 1 from the cumulative count to get the index of the sorted list. And then we just repeat the first 4 processes until all the unsorted elements are handled. Suppose we have these numbers to be sorted. So you can expect that the 3 ones will be put in front of the 3 twos followed by 2 threes and 1 four. In order to do the counting sort process, I need to find out the number of counts for each element. So for element 0, which is non-existent in the numbers to be sorted, the count must be 0. And for element number 1, we see that we have 1, 2, and 3 elements. So this value is 3. For 2, we also have 3 elements. So for 2, we have also 3 such elements. So the number of elements for 2 is 3. And for number 3, we have 2 3s. So the count is 2. And for number 4, I have only 1 4, so the count for 4 is just 1. And then from the number of counts of each element, I can find out the cumulative counts of the elements. So the first element is 0, and then the cumulative count is of course 0. Then for element number 1, the cumulative count is equal to the cumulative count of the previous element plus the number of elements for that particular number. So I will have 0 plus 3 to become 3, which is the cumulative count for element number 1. Then for element number 2, the cumulative count is simply equal to the cumulative count of the previous element plus the count for this particular element, which is 3. So I will have 6 when I just add 3 and 3 together. For element number 3, the count is 2. So the cumulative count for number 3 is simply equal to 6 plus 2, which is simply giving me 8, okay? And for element 4, the count is 1, and the cumulative count of the previous number is simply equal to 8. So I just add 8 by 1 to get 9, being the cumulative count of element number 4, okay? After I have got the cumulative count of the elements, I can do the sorting. So I simply start with the first element of the unsorted list, which is 2. So when I have number 2, I just find the cumulative count for element number 2. So I can find out 6 as the answer. And then when I do the placement of the element to the final answer, I just need to subtract 1 from the cumulative count to get the index. So I will get 5 because 6 minus 1 equals 5. It just means that I want to put element number 2 here to the index 5 position of the final answer, okay? Okay, after the subtraction of 1 from the original cumulative count, the new cumulative count for element number 2 becomes 5. Then I'm going to put the second element of the unsorted list, which is 1 here. And we can see that element 1 has a cumulative count of 3. And then I subtract 1 from 3 to get 2. So the index position of the element number 1 here is simply index number 2. So I put this element to index 2 position of the final answer. Now we see that the cumulative count for element number 1 becomes 2. And then we can try to put the third element of the unsorted list, which is simply equal to 1 here. And for 1, I check the cumulative count for that element, which is 2, and then I subtract 1 from the element cumulative count to get 1. So this value of 1 has to be put into index 1 of the final answer. And of course, the cumulative count for element number 1 becomes 1. And then I put the fourth number, which is 3, to the correct position of the answer. So element number 3 has a cumulative count of 8. And then I subtract 1 from 8 to get 7. So index number 7 should be the position of element number 3 to be put. Okay, so you see 3 is put here. And of course, after updating the cumulative count, the cumulative count for element number 3 becomes 7. Okay, and we are going to handle element number 4, which is actually the 5th element of the unsorted list. So you can see that for element number 4, the cumulative count is 9. And then I subtract 1 from 9 to get 8. So the element goes to index 8 of the final answer. So 4 is put here. After putting the number correctly, I have to update the cumulative count from 9 to 8. Okay. And then we handle the next element, which is 2. So for element number 2, the cumulative count is now 5. And then I subtract 1 from 5 to get 4. So index 4 would be the correct position of element number 2, which is this one. And after the placement of the previous number, I have to update the cumulative count for element number 2. Now it becomes 4, which is this one. Okay. And then I try to put another element which is inside the unsorted list. So I'm going to handle number 3. For number 3, the cumulative count is 7. And then I just minus 1 from 7 to get 6. So the correct position of this element is simply index 6. Okay, after putting the element correctly, the cumulative count is updated to be 6. Okay, and then I've handled the 8th element of the unsorted list, which is 2. So for number 2, the cumulative count is 4. And then I subtract 1 from 4 to get the index position of number 3. So this element is simply put to index number 3 of the final answer. And then I have to update the cumulative count from 4 to 3. Okay. And finally, I have the last element to be handled. This element has a cumulative count of 1. And then I subtract 1 from 1 to get 0. So index 0 should be the correct position of the element coming from the unsorted list. And we can see that all the numbers are already sorted in this particular order. 3 1s, 3 2s, 2 3s, and 1 4. In this case, the sorting process is now complete. Thank you for walking through the algorithm with me. If you have any questions about my video, please leave your questions on the comment section below the video. If you like this video, please give me a like and please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching.